Hey guys, the main point of this video is to show what will happen if you break an ampoule with rubidium in air. But if you watch this video till the end, you will also see a few interesting reactions with rubidium.
Cesium and rubidium are the rarest and the most expensive alkali metals. For instance, if you rub to bind 1 gram of rubidium, it will cost you about $100. However, the prices might differ when purchasing in bulk, and in this case rubidium might cost less than $20 per gram. Half of the price goes to prepacking and sealing an ampoule with rubidium.
Okay guys, take a look at this ampoule, containing 2 grams of pure metal rubidium. Before I crush it, I want you to see it boiling, forming thousands of tiny drops of liquid rubidium. Due to the low pressure of the ampoule, it doesn't need to be heated to 700 degrees Celsius, which is the boiling point of rubidium under normal conditions. While the ampoule cools down, you can observe rubidium crystallizing. Okay guys, now it's time to crush our precious ampoule with rubidium. Relax guys, of course I will not crush this ampoule. If I do, there will not be any reactions with rubidium that I promised. So instead, I will crush this ampoule. No wonder I can easily give you a demonstration of crushing a rubidium ampoule. Now that I have 11 supporters on my Patreon and can afford almost any chemical reagents thanks to them. By the way, if you want to help me making even more amazing videos that come out more often, you can join those 11 awesome people and become a member on my Patreon page, or just make a one-time donation on PayPal or Skrill. Actually, I have as many as 8 rubidium ampoules that I'll probably need for my upcoming videos. Take a look at this sheet, it's zirconium foil. I will use it as a surface to crush the ampoule on. So what we can see, pink purple, free from other ions, color of the flame in case rubidium lights up. As you might have noticed, rubidium didn't self-ignite in air. Rubidium is more similar in its properties to potassium than to cesium. Maybe if that was liquid rubidium, or if I had 10 more grams of the metal, it would self-ignite. Anyway, let's move on to fascinating reactions with rubidium. For this rubidium and oxygen reaction, I will use tantalum sheet the way I used zirconium foil earlier. I'm going to run a jet of oxygen through a piece of metal rubidium. Let's see if it ignites in this case. Now I'll drop a piece of rubidium in liquid oxygen. The reaction with liquid oxygen didn't occur, but what if we try to use liquid ozonated oxygen? This blue liquid is a mixture of liquid oxygen and ozone. It changed color from light blue to purple when the amount of ozone is increased. As well as other alkali metals, rubidium is freely soluble in liquid ammonia, forming blue rubidium solution that carries strong reducing properties. For example, it instantly reduces iodine from iodine trichloride, that my previous video was about. Really exotic reaction, right? Then I'll drop a piece of metal, rubidium and allium. Although this reaction will not be as impressive as the one with potassium, let's do this anyway, just because I can. According to Inorganic Chemistry Guide, rubidium silicide self-ignites in air and explosion. Well, let's check it out. I took a piece of metal rubidium and put it into a quartz test tube with silicon powder on top, added in excess, so that it will prevent rubidium from oxidizing. It's important because I will perform this reaction in a non-protective atmosphere. I waited till the test tube cooled down and now I'm pouring its contents out, hoping to see self-ignition and explosions. Now I'll try to heat up a piece of metal rubidium in a sulfur hexafluoride atmosphere. Here you can see the formation of yellow hint of elemental sulfur during the reaction. As well as other alkali metals, rubidium explodes on impact too if boron tribromide is dribbled on it beforehand. Now I'll show you how rubidium reacts with halogens. The first reaction will be a very beautiful one with iodine. To make the reaction occur, rubidium must be melted. To perform the reaction with chlorine, I need to get it first. To do this, I will use calcium hypochlorite, that I will add muriatic acid in. It is one of the best ways of getting chlorine at the lab. Rubidium must be heated for this reaction as well. Well, Mr. Rubidium, what will you say if I bath you in liquid chlorine? Before I finish this video, I'd like you to try to explain in the comments what is this you see right now. I'm strongly heating the ampoule with rubidium and it's gained on bronzish color. Where does this color come from? Thanks for watching, guys, and big thanks to all my patrons on Patreon. See you in the next video.